In this video, we will talk about the control of the heart by sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Let's get started with the control by the sympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic innervation is seen all over the heart. It supplies the SI node, conductive system, as well as ventricular musculature. Now, the first thing you need to understand regarding control by sympathetic nervous system is that sympathetic nerves are not completely inactive under resting condition. Let's say, if sympathetic activity can range from as low as this point to as high as this point, under resting conditions, it's active at this baseline level. This activity maintains the pumping of the heart about 30% above that without any sympathetic activity. Stimulation above this level increases the heart's activity. It occurs by an increase in the heart rate by stimulating the SI node, as well as increase in the force of contraction by stimulating ventricular musculature. The net result is increased cardiac output. On the other hand, inhibition of the baseline activity results in decreased pumping. It occurs by a decrease in heart rate due to a decrease in SI nodal activity and a decrease in the force of contraction by ventricular muscle fiber. The net result is a decrease in cardiac output. So, this was sympathetic control. Now let's see the control by parasympathetic nervous system. The heart receives parasympathetic innervation by the vagus nerve. It supplies the SI node and atria, but not the ventricles. This is very important difference that you should know. Ventricular muscles do receive sympathetic innervation, but the parasympathetic innervation is not significant. Coming to the effect. See, the duty of the parasympathetic nervous system is to calm down the heart. So, stimulation of parasympathetic nerves results in a decrease in heart rate. This is due to the effect on the SI node. There is not much effect on the force of contraction because the ventricular muscles do not receive as much parasympathetic innervation. Now, very strong stimulation of the vagus nerve can completely stop the heart. However, after a few seconds, the heart escapes from this effect and starts beating at a lower rate of 20 to 40 beats per minute. Apart from this effect on heart rate, a very strong stimulation can decrease the force of contraction to some extent. So this was the control by the parasympathetic nervous system. Now let's see these effects in the cardiac output curve. This graph shows the right atrial pressure on the x-axis and cardiac output on the y-axis. This is a line for the resting condition. It shows that with an increase in the right atrial pressure, there is an increase in cardiac output. This is because of the Frank-Starling mechanism of the heart. If you want to know the details about that mechanism, watch a separate video on that. Here we won't go in that detail. What we want to see here is how sympathetic and parasympathetic activity influences this curve. So let me show you curves for that. Here is the curve for stimulation of the sympathetic nervous system. You see, with sympathetic stimulation, the pumping by the heart increases. That means at any right atrial pressure, the heart pumps more blood if sympathetic nerves are activated. This line is for the inhibition of sympathetic nerves. It shows a decrease in the heart's activity. And this line is for parasympathetic stimulation. It also shows a decrease in the pumping. So this is how sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system affects the cardiac output curve. Now let's have a quick summary. Sympathetic nerves supply SI node, AV node, as well as ventricular musculature. Their stimulation increases cardiac output and inhibition decreases cardiac output. The parasympathetic nerves supplies mainly SI node and atria, but not much the ventricular muscles. Its stimulation decreases heart rate and very strong stimulation can even stop the heart for few seconds. That's it for this video. You can find the notes on this topic and explore our entire animation video library at our website. The links are in the description. If you found this video helpful, please hit like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.